So let's now have a look what few serializability means in contrast to finite state serializability. Few serializability is similarly defined. A schedule S is few serializable if there exists a serial schedule S prime such that S and S prime are few equivalent. Now all of these schedules which are few serializable are put together in a class called VSR. In addition, we require that these histories leave a consistent database state. But now, how is view equivalence defined? View equivalence looks at the reads the individual transactions are executing and the values they obtain. And view equivalence means that the read operation deliver the same values as in a serial schedule. So in this example, we have schedule VSR, and we see already there's one read operation and then it follows by quite few write operation and commits. This schedule contains a cycle and we want to investigate now if this history, the schedule, is few serializable or not. In order to do this, like in the previous examples, we assume a database with variables x, y, they're initially zero. And let's look at the read operations. We have only one read operation, which is here in the beginning. And consequently, we read a value of x equals to zero. How does this look like for a serial schedule? Here, the serial schedule we look at is T1, T2, T3. So everything from T1 first, then follows transaction 2 operations, and then the operations from T3. And not surprisingly, because we have T1 first, this only read, which is coming from T1, also delivers zero. And the other writes don't matter because we only look here for the VSR class on the read. And this means that this SVSR, the schedule we wanted to test, is equivalent, is few equivalent to S prime. Hence, the schedule here is few serializable, so it falls into the class VSR. So let's do now again the plausibility checks we also did for FSR, now for VSR, and we start looking at the lost update problem. Here you see a schedule L which contains the lost update problem. And again, we put in some concrete values here, and looking at the reads, we see transaction 1 is reading x equals 0, and transaction 2 is reading x equals 0. These are the only reads in our schedule. And now we look at the serial histories, serial schedules, and you see that here we're reading x equals 0. But here we're reading x equals 1. And the other way around, 0 and 1 for the transaction 2 and 1 before it was 1 and 2, right? You see that. Now, in any case, here we're reading 0, 0, and here we have a mixture out of 0 and 1, so it's clear that the reads are not the same as for L. That means none of these two serial schedules is equivalent, few equivalent to L. That means L is not in VSR. And that's actually good news because, well, we want that, right? We want to have these classes to not contain our lost update problem and the other problems, right? And that's good news. Let's continue. Here we see inconsistent read. Let's put in again some concrete values for our schedule here. Let's see how the reads look like. So we see here we're reading x equals 1, and here we have x equals 0 and x equals 1, and here we have y equals 0 and y equals 0, right? And you will see that it's not really important now to, in this example at least, to remember which transaction was reading, because it's clear, looking at the example, that these are not few equivalent to any serial history. And this is how we find out. Here's one serial history, and here's another one. Let's look at the reads. Here we are reading 0 for x, 0 for y, 1 for x, and 1 for y. But just by looking at the zero and ones, you see already that this is not the same as for this schedule here. Of course, in to be more precise, but the result will be the same for this example, you would have to look which transaction is reading which variable. But here, because it's so obvious, it's enough to look only at the variables that we read. So we read not the same as we have seen here. And how about this one? Well, here we have x equals 0, y equals 0. Here we have x equals 0 and y equals 0, so all zeros. And obviously this is also not the same as here, so none of these two serial histories is equivalent to I, hence I is not included in VSR. And that's also good news, right? So it seems VSR is solving all of our problems. And for the inconsistent read and for the plausibility check at least, and for the loss update, this seems to work out. Unfortunately, there's a theorem stating the complexity of the decision problem to find out whether or not a given schedule is contained in VSR. And this theorem says that the decision problem is NP complete. And as you all know, that's expensive to check. Hence, also VSR is out of the question to be used in our database system. It fulfills the requirements here, but then it's too expensive to test, so we cannot use it.